Horrid Henry, early reader. Moody Margaret cast a spell. Chapter 1.
You are getting sleepy, said Moody Margaret. You are getting very sleepy.
Slowly, she waved her watch in front of Susan.
So sleepy. You are now asleep. You are now fast asleep.
No, I'm not, said sour Susan.
When I click my fingers, you will start snoring.
Margaret clicked her fingers.
Click.
But I'm not asleep, said Susan.
Margaret glared at her.
How am I supposed to hypnotize you if you don't try? Said Margaret.
I am trying. You're just a bad hypnotist, said Susan sourly.
Now it's my turn.
No, it's not. It's still mine, said Margaret.
You've had your go, said Susan.
No, I haven't.
But I never get to be the hypnotist, wailed Susan.
Cry, baby, meanie, cheater, cheater, slap, slap.
Susan glared at Margaret. Why was she friends with such a mean, moody, bossy boots? Margaret glared at Susan. Why was she friends with such a stupid, sour sucker?
I hate you, Margaret, screamed sour Susan. I hate you more, screamed moody Margaret.
Chapter 2.
Shut up, landlubbers,
shrieked Horrid Henry from his hammock in the garden next door,
or the purple hand will make you walk the plank.
Shut up yourself, Henry, said Margaret.
Yeah, Henry, said Susan.
You are stupid, you are stupid, chanted rude Ralph, who was playing pirates with Henry.
You're the stupids, snapped moody Margaret. Now leave us alone, we're busy.
Henry, can I play pirates with you? Asked Perfect Peter, wandering out from the house.
No, you puny prawn, screamed Captain Hook. Out of my way before I tear you to pieces with my hook.
Mom, wailed Peter. Henry said he was going to tear me to pieces.
Stop being hurried, Henry, shouted Mom.
And he won't let me play with him, said Peter.
Can't you be nice to your brother for once? Said Dad.
No,
thought Horrid Henry. Why should he be nice to that tell-tale brat? Horrid Henry did not want to play pirates with Peter. Peter was the world's worst pirate. He couldn't sword fight. He couldn't swashbuckle. He couldn't remember pirate curses. All he could do was whine.
Okay, Peter, you're the prisoner. Wait in the fort, said Henry.
But I'm always the prisoner, said Peter.
Do you want to play or don't you?
Yes, Captain, said Peter.
He crawled into the lair of the purple hand. Being prisoner was better than nothing, he supposed. He just hoped he wouldn't have to wait too long.
Chapter 3.
Let's get out of here, quick!
Henry whispered to Rude Ralph. I've got a great idea for playing a trick on Margaret and Susan. He whispered to Ralph. Ralph grinned. Horrid Henry hoisted himself onto the low brick wall between his garden and Margaret's. Moody Margaret was still waving her watch at Susan. Unfortunately, Susan had her back turned and her arms folded.
Go away, Henry, ordered Margaret.
Yeah, Henry, said Susan. No boys.
Are you being hypnotized? Said Henry.
Margaret's trying to hypnotize me, only she can't cause she's a rubbish hypnotist,
said Susan.
That's your fault, said Margaret, glaring.
Of course, you can't hypnotize her, said Henry. You're doing it all wrong.
And what would you know about that? Asked Margaret.
Because, said Hurried Henry, I am a master hypnotist.
Moody Margaret laughed.
He is too a master hypnotist, said Ralph. He hypnotizes me all the time.
Oh, yeah? Said Margaret.
Yeah, said Henry.
Prove it, said Margaret.
Okay, said Henry.
Give me the watch.
Margaret handed it over. He turned to Ralph.
Look into my eyes,
he ordered.
Ralph looked into Henry's eyes. Now watch the watch, ordered Henry the hypnotist, swinging the watch back and forth. Rude Ralph swayed.
You will obey my commands, said Henry.
I will obey, said Ralph in a robot voice.
When I whistle, you will jump off the wall, said Henry.
He whistled. Ralph jumped off the wall.
See? Said Hurried Henry.
Chapter 4.
That doesn't prove he's hypnotized, said Margaret. You have to make him do silly things.
Like what? Said Henry.
Tell him he's got no clothes on.
Ralph, you're a nudie, said Henry.
Ralph immediately started running round the garden shrieking.
Ow! Yelped Ralph. I'm a nudie! I'm a nudie! Give me some clothes! Help! Help! No one look! I'm naked!
Margaret hesitated. There was no way Henry could have really hypnotized Ralph. Was there?
I still don't believe he's hypnotized, said Margaret.
Then watch this, said Hurried Henry. Ralph, when I snap my fingers, you will be Margaret.
Snap!
My name is Margaret, said Ralph. I'm a mean bossy boot. I'm the biggest, bossiest boot. I'm a frog face.
Margaret blushed red. Susan giggled.
It's not funny, snapped Margaret.
No one made fun of her and lived to tell the tale.
See? Said Henry. He obeys my every command.
Wow, said Susan. You really are a hypnotist. Can you teach me?
Maybe, said Hurried Henry. How much will you pay me?
He's just a big faker, said Margaret.
She stuck her nose in the air.
If you're such a great hypnotist, then hypnotize me.
Oops! Now he was trapped. Margaret was trying to spoil his trick. Well, no way would he let her.
Chapter 5. Hurried Henry remembered who he was.
The boy who got Miss Battle Axe sent to the head.
The boy who terrified the boggy babysitter.
The boy who tricked the tooth fairy. He could hypnotize Margaret any day.
Sure,
he said, waving the watch in front of Margaret.
You are getting sleepy,
droned Henry.
You are getting very sleepy. When I snap my fingers, you will obey my every command.
Henry snapped his fingers. Margaret glared at him.
Well, said Moody Margaret.
Don't you know anything?
Said Hurried Henry. He thought fast.
That was just the beginning bit. I will complete part two once I have freed Ralph from my power. Ralph, repeat after me.
I am sellotape.
I am sellotape,
said Rude Ralph. Then he belched.
I am burping sellotape,
said Rude Ralph. He caught Henry's eye. They burst out laughing.
Ha ha! Susan fooled you, shrieked Henry.
Did not, shrieked Susan.
Did too. Na 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 na.
Henry and Ralph ran round Margaret, whooping and cheering.
Come on, Margaret, said Susan. Let's do some real hypnosis.
Margaret didn't move.
Come on, Margaret, said Susan.
I am Sellotape, said Margaret.
No, you're not, said Susan.
Yes, I am, said Margaret.
Henry and Ralph stopped whooping.
There's something wrong with Margaret, said Susan. She's acting all funny.
Margaret, are you okay? Margaret, Margaret!
Chapter 6. Moody Margaret stood very still. Her eyes looked blank. Henry snapped his fingers.
Raise your right arm, he ordered.
Margaret raised her right arm.
Huh? Thought hurried Henry.
Pinch Susan!
Margaret pinched Susan.
Ow!
Yelled Susan.
Repeat after me.
I am a stupid girl.
I am a stupid girl, said Margaret.
No, you're not, said Susan.
Yes, I am, said Margaret.
She's hypnotized, said hurried Henry.
He'd actually hypnotized Moody Margaret.
This was amazing. This was fantastic. He really truly was a master hypnotist.
Will you obey me, slave?
I will obey, said Margaret.
When I click my fingers, you will be a chicken.
Click!
Squawk, squawk, squawk,
cackled Margaret, flapping her arms wildly.
What have you done to her?
Wailed Sour Susan.
Wow, said Rude Ralph. You've hypnotized her.
Hurried Henry could not believe his luck. If he could hypnotize Margaret, he could hypnotize anyone. Everyone would have to obey his commands. He would be master of the world, the universe, everything.
Henry could see it now.
Henry, 10 out of 10.
Miss Battleaxe would say,
Henry is so clever he doesn't ever need to do homework again.
Oh boy, would he fix Miss Battleaxe? He'd make her do the hula in a grass skirt when she wasn't running round the playground mooing like a cow. He'd make the head Mrs. Oddbod just have chocolate and cake for school dinners. And no PE ever! In fact, he'd make Mrs. Oddbod close down the school. And as for Mom and Dad,
Henry, have as many sweets as you like, Dad would say.
No bedtime for you,
Mom would say.
Henry, watch as much TV as you want,
Dad would say.
Henry, here's your pocket money, £1,000 a week.
Tell us if you need more, Mom would smile.
Peter, go to your room and stay there for a year,
Mom and Dad would scream. Henry would hypnotize them all later. But first, what should he make Margaret do? Ah, yes. Her house was filled with sweets and biscuits and fizzy drinks. All the things Henry's horrible parents never let him have.
Bring us all your sweets, all your biscuits, and a fizzy whiz drink.
Yes, master, said Moody Margaret.
Chapter 7. Henry stretched out in the hummock. So did Rude Ralph. This was the life. Sour Susan didn't know what to do. On the one hand, Margaret was mean and horrible, and she hated her. It was fun watching her obey orders for once. On the other hand, Susan would much rather Margaret was her slave than Henry's.
Unhypnotize her, Henry, said Sour Susan.
Soon,
said hurried Henry.
Let's hypnotize Peter next, said Ralph.
Yeah,
said Henry. No more telling tales, no more goody-goody vegetable eating, I'm Mr. Perfect. Oh boy, would he hypnotize Peter. Moody Margaret came slowly out of her house. She was carrying a large pitcher and a huge bowl of chocolate mousse.
Here is your fizzy whiz drink, master, said Margaret.
Then she poured it on top of him.
What,
spluttered Henry, gasping and choking.
And your dinner, frog face, she added, dipping the mousse all over Ralph.
Oh!
Wailed Ralph.
Na 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 na!
Shrieked Margaret.
Fooled you! Fooled you!
Perfect Peter crept out of the Purple Hand fort. What was all that yelling? It must be a pirate mutiny.
Hang on, pirates! Here I come!
Shrieked Peter, charging at the threshing hummock as fast as he could.
Crash!
A sopping wet pirate captain and a moose-covered first mate lay on the ground. They stared up at their prisoner.
Hi, Henry, said Peter. I mean, hi, Captain.
He took a step backwards.
I mean, Lord High Excellent Majesty.
He took another step back.
We were playing pirate mutiny, weren't we?
Die, worm!
Yelled hurried Henry, leaping up.
Mom!
Shrieked Peter.